There's so many different ways this thing could go. I would not rule out the Broncos getting a quarterback if they can. Maybe Trey Lance is a Bronco, by the way.
Yeah.
And everybody's saying that he, you know, might not be ready to go right now. And allegedly due to Larry Kruger's tweet, Larry Kruger tweeted out that Kyle Shanahan met with Trey Lance's parents.
Yep.
Basically, done deal is what Larry Kruger says. Oh. Larry Kruger did have a check mark. I think he is in San Francisco, a journalist in San Francisco. So he thinks it's Trey Lance. Yeah, Larry Kruger at Sports Larry KNBR. I heard last night, okay? Doesn't say from whom. Just last night he heard. 49ers met with Trey Lance's parents on their trip to Fargo. That sounds to me like Lance is their guy. And it jives with their public stance that Jimmy is still their guy this year, which would make a lot of sense, by the way, if they did that. But maybe Mac Jones also gets to sit in there and watch and just let me recall every single thing that Jimmy G did in the first 8-9 weeks before he go in there. This is what he should have done. So I have no idea, to answer your question, about what the hell is going to happen in that draft after the first three.
With Mac Jones, it kind of goes back to, you know, you always talk about, like, yeah, like the physical attributes. Everyone in the NFL is a stud physically, but between the ears is where it really matters. And it's more so if you're a quarterback. So it would make sense if it's like, hey, this guy's a savant. He can do everything. But also with that,
how come he's not even thought of to be one then? You know, is it just because Trevor Lawrence?
Because
is the guy?
I would assume because Trevor Lawrence is very similar in that regard, and then he's got all the...
I don't know if he is, by the way. This is not a normal... I don't think this is like a normal thing just to be like this next level smart, if that's what they're saying. Andrew Luck, by the way,
right,
was like next level smart. Maybe Trevor is the same exact way. He might be more of a football player as opposed to football player with photographic memory or whatever, but it is all in between the ears and how you act with everything.
Well, do you think it has to do a lot with mobility? Like, I feel like today a lot of quarterbacks have to have the, you know, possibility of, hey, you can run for a first down or something. And you were saying earlier about Mac Jones and pocket passing.
He might save pocket passing.
Yeah.
Mac Jones might save the pocket passer for another generation. You know what I mean? Because it felt like it was getting worked at.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, we're moving. We're grooving. This is the quarterback of the future. Patrick Mahomes, incredible passer, but he extends plays like anybody else. Aaron Rodgers extends plays. They're not your stereotypical pocket passer, even though all the quarterback gurus say he can move more than everybody thinks. It's like, I don't think that's what he's coming into the NFL to do.
Right.
They are bringing his ass in to be a pocket passer, and it makes sense if all these narratives that are coming out about his big-ass brain are true, why the incredible quick rise happened. And it's because it's in between the ears with him.
Do you think it is possible, though, for, like Larry Kruger was saying, for Lance to be the guy? Because what we've heard is that Shanahan's system's so complex, it takes all this time. But then we're also hearing that Mac Jones, like, he can pick it up incredibly quick. So, like, would he even – I mean, he would obviously benefit from still watching, but would he even need to go in and, like, sit behind Jimmy G and, like, learn the offense?
I have no idea what the hell's going to happen, huh?
No idea.
I mean, Trevor Lawrence is one. Zach Wilson allegedly guaranteed number two.